Good afternoon. We are all here today to celebrate the life of my gramps, Mr. Paul Philippus. As you know, his life was filled with music. It was a part of his faith, his family, his friends, and his work. Many of you got to be a part of that music that was his life. So if any of you are not a part of the service and you want to join in our celebration, please feel free, or just sit back and enjoy. So on behalf of the family, thank everybody for coming out today, and we're all grateful to have you. Okay.
Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall live also." Friends, we have gathered here this afternoon to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate Paul Philippus' life. We come together in our grief. We acknowledge our human loss. We pray that God will grant us grace, that in our pain we may find comfort, and in our sorrow, hope. We know that Paul has claimed the resurrection, and we are here to celebrate in a service of worship, with song and with remembrance. And so I invite you to begin in this concert of praise to worship the Lord.
Sweet little Jesus boy, they made you be born in a manger. Sweet little holy child, we didn't know who you was. Didn't know you'd come to save us, Lord, to take our sins away. Our eyes was blind, we couldn't see. Didn't know who you were. Long time ago, you was born in a manger low. Sweet little Jesus boy, the world treats you mean, Lord, treats me mean too. But that's how things is down here. We don't know who you is. You have told us how, and we are trying. Master, you done showed us how, even when you was dying. Just seems like we can't do right, look how we treated you. But please, sir, forgive us, Lord. Didn't know 'twas you. Sweet little Jesus boy, born long ago. Sweet little holy child, and we didn't.
Will you please join me in our opening prayer? It is printed for you on the worship guide or will be on the screen for you. Almighty God, our Father, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. You are our shelter and strength, our hope in troubled times. Grant us your blessing in this hour, and help us so to put our trust in you that our spirits may grow calm and our hearts be comforted. Lift our eyes beyond the shadows of earth and help us to see the light of eternity. May we find grace and strength for this and every time of need through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As you're able, I invite you to stand and sing with me, How Great Thou Art, number 77 in the United Methodist Hymnal.
Thank you. First, a reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verse 31. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Our second reading is also from the book of Isaiah, chapter 55. Chapter 55, verse 12. For you shall go out in joy and be led back in peace. The mountains and the hills before you shall burst into song, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. And finally, Psalm 150. Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty firmament. Praise him for his mighty deeds. Praise him according to his surpassing greatness. Praise him with trumpet sound. Praise him with lute and harp. Praise him with tambourine and dance. Praise him with strings and pipe. Praise him with clanging cymbals. Praise him with loud clashing cymbals. Let everything that breathes praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Thank you.